Hello, welcome in my workshop. I'm an international field service engineer, self-employed, and I have a crazy hobby, which is building solar boats. Behind me on the trailer, there is my solar boat, Cynthiano, and it's 8 meters long. It is 2.2 meters wide, and it weighs about 800 kilograms. Later in this video, I will open the boat up so you can see various parts of the boat and how she works. And but it's a bit of a process. Now she is in a transport mode. This is how I transport her on the road. Open trailer. I have some tail lights sticking on the back, which I remove when I'm on the water. Hello, videos. I have a flex inside, which I will show, and I will just fire it up and have the engine running and stuff like that. So now I'm raising the roof a bit, which is a bit slow, but I will spare you the whole raising, just show you the principle. I'm using 24 volt actuators meant for the roof windows, basically.
As you can see now, the boat is open, which means this is how I sail it with my family. You see the back couch. There are two front seats, which I will show you later when we are inside. One is a really low seat, so I can lower the roof to clear really low bridges. The rest of the family will sit on the floor then, but it enables me to get to small villages where there is water, which is really nice here in the Netherlands. I will show you now how the hole is made and why it's made like that in the rest of this video. So this is a look underneath the hole. As you can see, it has a V shape. Basically, the sides of the boat are in the water and the bow wave is allowed to get away underneath the boat. And it also helps lifting the boat a bit when the speed gets a bit higher. And that creates also a lot of bubbles under the boat. And that in turn reduces the water resistance and enables me to get about 10 kilometers an hour with only 2.8 kilowatts of motor power. This is another look underneath the boat, but then from the back you see a big gaping hole over there, which is close to the side. This is where the drivetrain stick through. It's stuck up now for transport. Also able to take the propeller upwards from inside of the boat, so I can clear it from any weed or plastic or other contaminations in the water. Another reason the boat is shaped this way, it creates more stability. I need a lot of stability because the roof, which is now in a high position now, is like 80 kilograms of solar panels, so that raises the center of gravity. And therefore, for safety reasons, I need more stability. So now I opened up the back hatch. You can see a big burn mark here on one of the parts of the back hatch, which are basically two solar panels. I used to have a homemade motor controller, but it went up in flames when I tried to boost the power. And that was a big mistake, but well, we got alive to the shore. I managed to extinguish the fire because I had a fire extinguisher on board. Here you see the motor, which is a PGM 132, a German made motor, a disc motor, and it runs on 24 volts in my case. It has a maximum current of 110 amps. Here you see the propeller, which is tucked up now for transport. Here we have my forklift motor controller. It's a nice programmable piece of device. This is half of the battery bank, which is lithium batteries. The little circuit board on top prevent overvoltage. Next to it you will see the big fuses which I can use to cut all the power in case of any fire or whatever kind of emergency. Here we have the other battery bank. You see some red cables on wheels. Those are used to steer the boat. I will show you that later when I let down the motor so you can see it working. In this big hose there are basically the motor cables. It has to be flexible because the whole motor turns. The motor is able to turn 160 degrees and this enables the boat to basically turn on the spot. Okay, I let the motor down now, so it's basically in its sailing position. I will turn the steering wheel so you can see how the mechanism works and how the boat is steered. So I have to put down the camera, which is just my mobile phone, walking to the front steering wheel. So here I am. I'm sitting on the back seat now. Another place on the back seat. It's pretty comfortable. Looking forward, you see the dash, you see the steering wheel. You see another passenger seat which can turn around. This box here is basically used to transport the batteries, but I've made it into a fridge. It runs on a 24 volts compressor, and 24 volts is basically the power, the voltage on which everything runs on board this boat. There are a couple of things running on 12 volts, of course, like the radio in the dash over there. So I have a little DC to DC converter installed. I have some USB outlets to have the kids charge their phones. Well, you know how young kids are. Another look in the fridge. It has a nice light, a temperature gauge. You hear it running now. Here we have my dash. So I got all kinds of buttons to control all kinds of stuff, like just switching on the main relay, the main power relay, switching on the main motor relay. I have a voltage indicator, various current indicators, which is basically showing me the current of the solar I'm getting, the current of the motor, and I'm having the battery current over here. So, to switch on the motor, the throttle over there needs to be in neutral position. If I don't, I see a red light, which basically disables me to engage the motor. So here I am, I'm in the captain's seat. You see a dial in the middle of the steering wheel, which is basically an indicator of the position of the propeller which is steering the boat. And so when I turn it, you can see the dial change. You see now the black indicator is in the 1 o'clock position. It basically means that the propeller turned like 30 degrees. So it's now in a 30 degrees angle. So I can see whenever I operate the throttle, I have an idea where the back of the boat is pushed to. So, turning back. So, I'm going to start the motor. You hear a big click, it's basically the main contactor of the motor. And here I have my throttle. Now you hear a hum of the motor. You see it making, the motor now makes like 150 RPM a minute.
This RPM indicator is just a very cheap one meant for automotive, so I used a induction sensor on the propeller shaft to measure the RPM. Well, this is the max RPM when the motor is free running. It's not in the water now. When it's in the water, it will be about 500 RPM. So now I'm in the passenger seat, looking at the back seat and at my wonderful burn mark on one of the solar panels. So the boat has 8 solar panels, and every solar panel is like 265 watt peak, but in total, in the ideal circumstances, I only get like 1800 watts of it. But that's more than enough to have a speed of like 8 to 9 kilometers an hour. So, and of course I can also add some battery juice to it, so I can get up to 2.8 kilowatts on the motor, which is the max speed of the boat. So here's the fridge. You got the captain's seat, got the dash, and underneath here is just empty space. I basically use it to store all kinds of stuff. Here I got a pole which I can use to grab the shore or to unfasten ropes, stuff like that, which you need on a boat. Here you look at the dusty front hatch, which is also 2 solar panels. You see the radio antenna. Here we got some buttons to operate the roof when I'm outside the boat. You see the underside of the Yingli solar panels, which work very fine for me. I got some inspection hatches. I can open one of those. There we go. A bit of violence. You see the inside of the boat. You see a reinforcement of carbon fiber. I use this inspection hatch to look into the keels of the boat. I have 2 keels in the boat, and I sometimes look into it if there's any water, if there's any leaks. But until now, I have it for 2 years now, there are no leaks. The whole boat is made out of plywood, but I reinforced the whole outside with carbon fiber. So it's a lot of epoxy, a lot of carbon fiber, and the boat turned out to be very strong and very stable. I had some waves and stuff. I bumped into the shore when I was learning to steer it. So, and it doesn't really sustain any damage at all. So this is a look underneath the couch, basically, which is containing some technical stuff. It's rather messy, but well, it's an everlasting experiment. But I used the boat for 2 years now, so who cares? So this is my charge controller. It's a FlexMax, Outback FlexMax. It has a maximum current of 80 amps. We're inside now, so there's not much charging going on. I think nothing at the moment, but it's okay. When it's in the workshop, I use a charger. When it's outside, I never use a charger. I just don't need it. I just need some light, and it does not have to be sun. Even in cloudy days, it will charge. So I got some fuse boxes over here, a relay box for the roof, a divider for the solar panels, basically with some diodes to prevent them from charging each other. Here, that little box over there is to program my motor controller and to read stuff. This is my main relay box. This is where I measure currents, measure voltage, and it has some main fuses. I can switch off the solar power here as well. It also contains my 24 to 12 volt converter. here I got my compressor for my fridge. So yeah, well, in a hot day you might want to have a beer in the afternoon. Here we are at the back of the boat. I see I have my tail lights still on, which looks like crap, but well, you have to have them for road transport. This is my backlight basically, so it's I actually did sail in the dark. The battery power enables me to sail in the dark for some hours, depending on the power I'm using. When I'm using max power, it will be about an hour and a half. Here I opened the front hatch. There's actually nothing important to see in the front hatch. Just a bit of a glance how I made the hole. Here you see that I also covered the inside of the bow. I covered it in carbon fiber just to help it absorb the impact of waves and stuff like that. Here you see a bit of the steering mechanism. It's very simple, just use a stainless steel cable. So I have some flag posts on the back of the boat as well. So here you got the official nameplate. And of course we are on the back of the boat again, marking basically the end of this video. Just another gadget I wanted to show you. Maybe you already seen it on my YouTube channel. It's a little joke I made for my kids. It's a mini solar boat. It has a bendable solar panel at the top. So you can sit in the shade. You don't need to burn your face in the sun all day. And well, it has a trolling motor on the back, which is steered by cables, by just bicycle cables. Also on this boat I used the discarded material, which I really like recycling old stuff and make it into something else. The frame of the solar panel is just a normal PVC pipe. The rolling motor. Here we got our little dash. It also has a USB charger for phone. And of course a voltmeter. Maybe I can switch it on. There we go. This boat runs on a 12 volt battery. Here I got a throttle control, which is basically three positions forward, three positions backwards. There we go. Max power. And backwards and go, of course. This is a current meter, two directions, so I can also see a charger charging whenever the solar is doing anything. Now it's in a workshop, so it's doing nothing. Switch off. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, just leave a message at my Facebook page. I have a special page for the Santiano. And of course I have my YouTube channel, which also has movies about the boat actually sailing, so you can see it performing. Bye bye.